Good morning, students. Today we can see management process. Yesterday you saw now what is the difference between management and administration. What is the definition of management? Everything you saw. So today you can see what are the management process. What is process? A process is something that what a person does. What a person, that is a manager, does in the context of his individual duties and responsibilities. Each and every manager have some duties and responsibilities, no? So what they are doing on behalf of their responsibilities and duties are termed as process. Today we are going to learn about the management process. What and all the processor, that is duties and responsibilities of a manager or the management. Okay, so what was the purpose of management process? There are two purposes. First one is maximum productivity or profitability. See, there are two purpose of management process. First one is maximum productivity or profitability. Second one is maximum human welfare and satisfaction. These are the two purpose of management process. First one is maximum productivity. They wants to maximize the production in order to increase the profitability. Then the second one is maximum human welfare. They wants to provide welfare activities to the social people and satisfaction, satisfy the human wants and needs. So these are the two main purpose of management process. Once again I will explain. First one is maximum productivity or profitability. Each and every management aim to maximize their productivity and profitability. Then the second one is maximum human welfare and satisfaction. It is necessary to satisfy human wants, and thereby they can satisfy, they can provide maximum human welfare. So these are the two purposes of management process. Now you can see there are five parts of management process. Five parts. There are five parts of management process. So that we can see in detail. See, first one is management is coordination. That is, in the definition we saw, no, management, what are the manager is to coordinate. That is, management is coordination. Manager is an enterprise, must effectively coordinate all the activities. So that's why management is coordination. They wants to coordinate all the M's. What are the M's? Men, machine, material and money. They have to coordinate all these four M's. Okay. That is why we will say that management is coordination. That is coordinating all the four M's. Men, machine, material and money. Then the second one is, second process is, management is a process. See, a manager wants to achieve proper coordination by means of managerial functions. What are all the managerial functions? Planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So these are the managerial functions. So this managerial management is a process which carries all these functions: planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So management is a process. Then the third one is management is a purposive process. What is the purpose of the management? To achieve their goals or objectives. That is the third process. Management is a purposive process. That means the management wants to determine the goals and objectives . So, the achievement of goals and objectives are an important process. Then the fourth one is, management is a social process. Here we can see that all the activities cannot be done by the management. They want to get the things done through other people. So many people are working in the organization. So, activities are done by the organization, employees, workers, like that. The management can direct them, implement policies and strategies and guide them. But all the activities are done by the other people. So, management is a social process. It is the art of getting things done through other people. Other people are doing the activities in the organization. That is why the management, it is an art of the management to getting things done by others. Okay, make the others to do the work. So this is the fourth process. Then the next one is, fifth and the last one is, management is a cyclical process. Here, what is meant by cyclical process? It represents planning, action, control, replanning cycle. Planning, action, control, replanning. First planning them, then put into action, then control them. Again, they want to replan like that. This is a process. So, put the plan, put into action, then control all the activities. So this is an ongoing process. That's why it is a cyclical process, like a cycle that is going on. First they plan, then action, then control, that is going on like that. So these are the five parts of management process. There are five parts that are explained one by one. See, once again I will explain short, briefly. First one is, management is to coordination. Managerial persons or management have to coordinate all the four M's, men, material, machine and money. Then the second one is, management is a process, because it is a process of planning, organizing, staffing, controlling and directing. All these are done by the management. Then the third one is, management is a purposive process. Their main management aim is to achieve goals and objectives. So they are directing towards the achievement of goals and objectives. Then fourth one is, management is a social process, because we can say that things are done by the other people. Then the last one is, management is a cyclical process. It represents planning, action, control, replanning, like that it will goes. Okay, so these are the five parts of our process of management. Thank you, students.